The Falmouth Commodores are just moments away from taking on the Harwich Mariners. I'm Joanne Bethay here with Matt Levine and David Adar. And before we talk about today's matchup, we're going to talk about yesterday. Overall, I think the team looked good. Guys were hot at bat, and we were seeing them clicking defensively a lot better than we had seen before, especially Anthony DeFabia. He was just lights out on the mound.
I mean, yeah, he went four innings yesterday, but he looked like he was the most solid pitcher we've seen. I know David said it last night on the broadcast and in the pregame show. He was the most solid on the mound this season of any Falmouth Commodore. He went four innings, had four strikeouts, and he did not allow Hyannis to score a run. So if you can put up numbers like that in the middle of a ball game, you give your offense a chance to win, and that's exactly what they did last night.
I think DeFabia, but I think you just have to look at the whole pitching staff for this Commodores team. Last night was their best outing of the season, only giving up three runs to a Hyannis team that battled back late. And I think it was definitely a closer game than we expected as the contest went on. But as a whole, the offense was a little quieter last night for the Commodores, and the pitching staff kind of helped make up for that. And in the end, Commodores come away with their second road win of the season.
What do the two of you think about the decision to take out DeFabia, even though he was performing so well?
I think Trundy made the right move because DeFabia, I mean, I don't know exactly how long he's gone. If that was the longest outing of his collegiate career, I don't know. But as a middle reliever, so to say, in that situation, you let him go the four innings, kind of ran out of gas at the end, but he still did not allow a run, and then you give it off to a guy like Mike Esposito at the back, or Chase Jeter came in and set them down in order, then Mike Esposito comes in absolutely throwing gas. So if you hand it off to the back end of the bullpen in a situation like that, I think that's the right thing to do.
Yeah, last night was DeFabia's second outing of the season for the Commodores. In his first outing, he went three innings, so you upped the inning total last night, but I mean, these guys aren't here to get their arms blown out. They're here to show off to scouts and to be preserved for games to use in the future. So, yes, DeFabia had his stuff working on the mound, and he was pitching phenomenally for the Commodores last night. I'll continue to say it. I think it was the best outing that any Commodores pitcher has had this season. But I think the fact that he was already four innings in, you don't want to stretch him too much, especially this early in the season when we still have a lot of games left. And so I thought it was a smart move by Coach Trundy, and in the end, the bullpen continued to hold that lead for Falmouth.
Well, I was able to catch up with him earlier today, so let's take a look at that interview. I'm here with Anthony DeFabia. Now, Anthony, you had a very successful outing yesterday. How were you able to settle in and be so incredible?
Well, it helped that Frenchie was calling a lot of good pitches behind the plate, so I just tried to stick with what I know I do best, and that's just get ahead and throw strikes. So once I did that, I found some success.
What pitches were you say were working well for you yesterday?
I had a good two-seam. They had a lot of lefties in the lineup, so I was throwing a lot of two-seams, and then I had a changeup and a slider that were working pretty well, so the combination of all three kind of helped out.
What can we expect from you going forward?
I'm just going to try to be me. I'm not going to try to do too much and try to do anything special, and just, you know, keep throwing strikes and competing and trying to get guys out.
Awesome. Thank you. Good luck today. So now that brings me to today's matchup against the Harwich Mariners. They only have one win, that win being Hyannis, who we were able to beat tonight, yesterday. What do you think of today's game?
Well, I think it's going to take another complete performance like we saw last night. The pitching was there, the hitting was there, and timely offenses on when they were at bat, and the fielding too. You talk about one error last night, but it's been a little bit worse than that in every game so far. So to limit those errors and then also have the timely hits and continue their pitching, I think they're in a good spot in every game that they play this season.
This Harwich team has only scored 7 runs all season. And you look at the Commodores, who in their first 3 games scored 7 runs at least in each of those games. Quite the difference between these two sides. So I definitely think that this Commodores team comes in playing well. They are still looking for that first home win of the season. They have a tie and a loss here at the Gov. So I know they're definitely hungry to get that first win here tonight. And I think they have an opponent that they match up well with.
We've seen a lot of different skills from many of the different players. Who would you say would be your player to watch as of right now?
I think tonight, you go off last night, it's Jonathan French, the catcher. If he does get the start tonight, look for him. I mean, he broke out yesterday, so to say, with a double and a solo home run. That home run was an absolute laser over the left center field wall. And we watched him in batting practice yesterday, just It seemed like there was something working for him, and we've seen that all season, but last night he was able to really put it together in game, and if he can carry that over and make it sort of an everyday thing, it's going to be big for Falmouth.
And I think what made last night so great for Jonathan French was the fact that he came in still looking for that first base hit, and the two times that he ended up coming around to score, he was the first two runs for Falmouth. Both came with two outs, and so a good job there late in the at-bats and late in innings of getting on base or, like Matt mentioned, hitting that first home run of the season, picking up a couple of hits for the first time here with Falmouth, and he'll look to continue that today if he gets the start.
Yeah, I have to say I'm a little biased, but I like your answers, choosing the Clemson guy. Now, going on to the other team, Harwich, who would you say is the guy to watch there?
Well, we know Cade Beloso starting in the DH spot, the first baseman and outfielder from LSU. The scouts say a lot about this guy, but mostly the power in his lefty bat. And early in this season, he's been raking. The power hasn't been there, but the singles have, and just getting on base. So him in the four spot tonight, Falmouth's going to really have to hone in on him.
Yeah, Cade Beloso is definitely going to be the guy to watch out for on this Mariners team. Like Matt mentioned, the big bat hasn't really come out yet. He only has one extra base hit so far this season, but he's 6-for-13 early on in the season, and he comes in as the top hitter in the CCBL through the first few games. So he's going to be a tough out for this Falmouth team, but I know that they definitely are up for the task and look forward to trying to retire him as many times as possible.
Going to be a fun matchup tonight. Both teams hungry for a win. Matt, going to you first. Who gets the dub?
I think the Commodores, if they're able to go in a balanced attack the way they did last night, I mean, I really don't see in any scenario that if a team brings good pitching and good hitting, you put yourself in a spot to win. So I'll leave it at that.
I definitely think this Commodores team comes in playing really strong baseball, and they're going up against the Harwich team, which has really struggled offensively this season. The pitching's been there, but the offense just hasn't. So it's a pretty conclusive decision for this Falmouth team. Taking the Commodores.
Love it. Well, I'm Joanne Bethay, signing off for myself, Matt, and David. Continue watching our live broadcast of tonight's game.